What's up, y'all? It's the Majin 9. It's time for another one. See, we're out here enjoying a lovely day of the hyperspace run. Hope you're having a great day out there. And today we're going to talk a little Ripperverse. Now, I know this has been a hot topic basically for this whole week. We're finally at our first full week of this. And we are at over $2.5 million for this campaign, which is fantastic. It's phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. And with that success, we've seen Eric, Mr. July, Ripper, Young Ripper 5'9". Getting a little bit of his hate, but we're not going to talk about that. We're not going to talk about the people who are losers, who can't seem to appreciate when somebody's doing well, that helps you do well too. If they're paving the way to do something good, and you go along that beaten path, that's a way for you to do good too. But we're going to ignore those people. What we're going to do today is aside from all of the good numbers and everything, I want to talk about some theories, right? Because I'm saying right now, I did not get the cards. I got the comic, but I didn't get the card. So I'm gonna be basically spitballing right now. Obviously nobody got anything yet because they haven't delivered yet. So I'm gonna definitely be spitballing as far as what I think is gonna be going on, right? So if you go by the quick synopsis that was given, so you could actually do right here. We can read this: Avery Summers is a common rancher, but it wasn't always the case. After obtaining some unique abilities, Avery spent a brief stint being a superhero under the moniker Isom in the city of Flare Park, Texas. Realizing that this wasn't for him, he walked away from this life. But after responding to a call from his sister, some violent altercations ensue. Avery is reconsidering his approach. What happened? Grab Isom number one to find out. Items were shipped August 22. And yes, there are international shipping. So yeah, so basically something goes down, right? And apparently it was Altina who calls up her brother, and he goes to investigate a missing friend of hers, right? Which has him get involved with one of his older friends from back in the day, who's now basically a crime boss, for so to speak, right? And I think this is me thinking right here. We're going to scroll down here because I don't know this guy's name. I'm probably drawing a break. He probably did say it, but again, we are going. So this guy right here, I'm thinking when he goes to find out about what's going on with her, you know, his sister's missing friend, he runs into this guy who definitely was somebody he dealt with before in the past. And from what it looks like Isom's abilities is more strength-based. Doesn't look like he has flight, and I don't see any energy around him. So that to me says something, right? So he has power, but I think he has some limitations to it. Now, one thing I will say that watching Ripper's live stream the other day, he did say that he is open to the point that there could be some growth to these characters. Like, they're not going to be stagnant, you know, with some certain training, whatever, they get better with things, which I like that idea. I like that. Now, as long as you keep it realistic, where it's not like, for lack of a better word, the Dragon Ball thing, where you constantly keep getting so big that it gets absurd at some point. But what I think happens is, him getting into this fight right here, so now remember what he said, something happened in his past, right, that made him put down the hero thing, right? So I think that's where the concept of this fight here, where you see him fighting Yara, I think she has something to do with his past, right? Now, she's probably pissed off at him. Either they were a team and he left her, or maybe somebody she was close to was working with him, and they got injured or hurt, and she blames him. Because what I see here, when you look at this panel, I know I'm scrolling up and down because I don't really have. So right here, you see Yara looking at the Alpha Corps, right? As if they, and I think she's getting into it with them. The way the Alpha Corps looks to me, right? They're in a similar uniform. I'm going to say, this is my theory, I think they are either local or state government, or maybe even federal government agents that come around because they noticed that there's some shenanigans going on. So with this fight here ends up leading to Yara getting involved. And then once Yara gets involved, because she seems like she's like like has more energy based powers, right? And she can fly, it looks like. This gets the attention of the Alpha Corps. And then obviously she gets involved, and I think she scuffles with them a little bit too, because she probably has no love for them either. But she definitely has a problem with Isom also. So I think that's where we're going to go with this. And like I said, all of this happening, right? All of this happening, this commotion going on, right? Because again, what Ripper said, the whole thing about his characters would have the ability to get stronger. I'm thinking that, like, with the time that happened between Avery, putting down the cape and then coming back, he's probably gotten stronger, you know, over time. Maybe he's been still training, you know, doing a farming ranging thing. Probably still keeping up on his power, right? Because that would be dumb. Like, we don't want to have him do, like, the Gohan treatment. I know I'm bringing a lot of Dragon Ball Z stuff up. But it's still the point that where he just basically stopped training, right? I think he was still training. Maybe he gets more powerful. Which then, all of this commotion happening, right, brings us to this guy, right? So, I don't know what his name is. Again, I don't have the cards. I'm probably going to have to get that at a later date. He says the cards are probably not going to run out. So, I'm probably going to have to get those at a later date. But, those cards look awesome, and they look like they have some information that I need. So with this guy, I'm just going to call him the alien, right? I don't have a good name for him, so we're going to call him the alien. But what's about him, like if you watch the little clip here, he basically seems like he's on the level of I know I got to do some comparisons because this is new, so I don't have anything to go by. So I'm going to say he's more along the lines of the Watcher, but he gets involved. Right, he gets involved because he's looking for new recruits for his, you know, campaign that he's having to go through. So with all the ruckus that's going down in Texas here, right, it gets on his radar. He's looking at, wait a minute, these humans are starting to kick up some power levels that could be useful to me, right? Because all of this happening right now is small change. This is basically, you know, street level. This is government street level, you know, stuff going on like this here. But if they get the attention of cosmic beings, there's definitely something out there that is far worse than, you know, a missing persons thing going on, right? So I think that's a little quick thing of what I think is going to be going down. Again, this is all me just theorizing. I am not 100% sure. Obviously, there's way more characters here. Like, if you look at the shirt here, there's more people here. I just wanted to go more focus on the ones that were, you know, in the forefront of, like, the supers, basically, the excepts is what he called them. So, that's what my theory is on this. And like I said, I'm really interested in this guy here, the alien. I want to see what he's about. I definitely like those cosmic beings again. So my thing is, as long as they have, if they have some progression in the story where you can see your characters get stronger, they're not stagnant, they don't hit a wall, but they don't get super crazy, right? Like, that's one thing I will give, like, the big twos, like, they don't have that thing where things get out of control. Sure, you might have your God-tier Superman and stuff like that, you know, but, and like, King Thor, like, you can have people get, like, really super powerful over time. That's cool and all, right? But that actually explains them, because they're more of a, you know, on the levels of cosmic type deals. But I think Isom definitely building up. Maybe he does learn to fly at some point, you know what I'm saying? That'd be cool, because from what I'm looking at, it doesn't look like he has flight abilities. So, yeah, definitely something to look forward to. Like I said, the campaign has 67 days left. We are at 2.5 million. Let's see if we get a little more before we get out of here, because I know it did go up a hair before. Yep, it did. We went up $1,000. That's nice. I don't know how much more this is going to go. I mean, I said that I foresee it doing Demon Slayer numbers, and right now we are past, like, the two lower tier Demon Slayer books that came out in 2021. Now the main one was at 5 million. If we can hit 5 million, that'd be great. Still have about a little over two months to go, so it is a possibility. But if it stops at 2.5 or maybe even 3 million, that's still a super crazy accomplishment, and I'm very proud of this. Proud of everybody involved, man, because everybody's definitely, you know, stepping up for this. And like I said, we don't know what's going on with this thing, and that shit makes it pretty awesome. So anyway, before we get out of here, big shouts to Georgia Giant Slayer, one of my Spellbreaker members. And if you want to get a shout out on the Hyperspace Fund, you become a Spellbreaker member, and all of my other members, I really appreciate you also. You will get a shout out in the description. But other than that, I really appreciate you guys, and let me know how you feel about these ideas I have, and do you have any of your own? Let me know how you feel about that. Like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and if you want to support this channel, you can hit that super thanks. And remember, you can't be good, be good at it, and ride safe out there. Peace. Satisfied with that, 'cause you're greedy.